Light in the Forest is a new children's picture book from Canadian artist Holly Carr. Its message is a timely one for all of us. Holly joins us this morning from Halifax. Good morning. And Holly, I'm going to start off by setting the scene with the start of your book. It starts off, "It is dark. Do not be afraid. There is light in the forest." And that darkness could be all kinds of fears, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I began this project a couple of years ago. Everything was culminating this spring. And here, look what we're in the middle of. So absolutely it can, yes.
Mm-hmm. And it's like adults and children, right? And right now for us, a lot of that darkness is uncertainty. And it's because of the pandemic, whether we're in lockdown. I don't know what the situation is right now in Halifax. I know you're also uncertain because of the weather in Halifax right now.
Yes, we're at the end of a hurricane.
Yes.
So absolutely. The book, this project, Light in the Forest, is bigger than the book. It's actually a theatrical production. It's now a virtual world that I'll be piloting in a university here in Atlanta, Canada. It's a message that no matter how bad things can get, they will get better. And just to keep a hold of that, I began the whole project based on my son's anxiety. He really suffered, especially in the nighttime, and he loved animals. So I started Light in the Forest. I turned it into an art installation. We've had some very tragic events around some young folks in my community and friend group. So I brought it back and I want to spread the message a little bit further. So it started with this book. It's become a very big project, and I hope we can reach as many people as we can, young and old.
Mm-hmm. Because the book kind of goes from, we're showing some photos from it right now. The book goes from just kind of the eyes and darkness surrounds it into the actual animals. So don't be afraid of them. It's just what you can't see that makes you afraid, right?
Yeah, they're a metaphor really for fear and for hope. So when you see, the idea of seeing something or not understanding something, and once you do, it becomes less stressful or less frightening. So I'm using the animals. So those eyes glowing in the dark, and what could they be? And so then you see this sort of ferocious looking animal and think, oh, this is, and then if you just sort of say your mantra, I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid. And then when you look a little deeper, then you see the light. And so in this case, it's the animals. You'll see them maybe with their young or sleeping on the forest floor or smelling the flowers, eating the apples, what have you. So it's just a way of bringing you into a peaceful situation, and to move out of the dark.
And letting you know that the animals themselves are also afraid, right?
Absolutely. And if you look at, in the big black and white illustration, which is actually behind me, that's the original painting behind me, you see all of them come together by the end of, you going through all of your fears. And then it's like the accumulation of fear, too. And so all of a sudden, it's all around you and feels a little overwhelming. And you just sort of hold tight, get yourself centered, give yourself a mantra, calm yourself down. And when you do, and you open your eyes again, you can see a brighter future, a brighter present day.
So right,
that,
right.
You flip that page, you get to see the animals all in their glory in the sunlight. And it's a way of bringing your brain there too.
Now, you mentioned the art installation before. So you do silk paintings, right? All the illustrations from the book, were they originally silk paintings as well?
Absolutely, yeah. So what you're seeing is probably the installation being built. This is
yes.
The beginning of the art installation. Now it's a huge theatrical production that we've turned into a virtual world because of COVID. So hopefully you'll be able to see it online before Christmas. There are dancers, there's music. It's all of the arts brought together to tell the same message that the book is telling.
Okay.
Also a song with children singing it, and it follows through with the same as the book. So it's all one giant project, one giant message. And that silk that you're seeing there, some of those are 50 by 13 feet tall, 50 feet wide, and the book illustrations are quite large also. If you can see behind me, this one is probably about 8 by 4 feet, this particular illustration.
Right. Thank you for writing a beautiful book with a beautiful message. It's called Light in the Forest, and Holly Carr has joined us from Halifax. Nice to chat with you today.
Oh, thank you.
There is trouble in the forest.